another edition of the program Community in Focus. The festival period is over and I hope you had a great time. Igbere community is a suburban center in Bende local government area. The people have a rich culture that is unique and peculiar to the people. One of such cultures is the Zumezu Cultural Festival that takes place every 3 years. The people celebrated a triannual event last year. It took place on 26th and 27th December 2017. One of the cardinal programs that take place during the cultural fiesta is the bottom man. It is a time when members of a particular age grade, after the attainment of a certain age, retire from community service and hand over the party to the younger ones. Last year's Zumezu Cultural Festival attracted the number one citizen of the country, President Muhammadu Buhari. He was represented by a special advisor on media and publicity, Femi Adesina. So, on today's edition of the program, we are focusing our attention on Igbere community.
Igbere in Bende local government area of Abia State is an expansive community, sharing borders with neighboring communities of Item, Alai, Ozuitem, Umuhu, and Abreba. Like many claims made by historians, there are various views that the Igbo migrated from Igbere and therefore the center of civilization.
Ancestral head of the Igbo race, and you will see it in Eke Igbere, the ancestral home of the Igbo race. So when you are hearing that Igbos are from Israel, it is Igbere they are talking about.
Igbere is a community of great merchants and warriors, a city on a hill of lush vegetation, luxurious green fields and expanse of virgin lands. 13 communities make up the Igbere nation, namely Ibinuku, Umusi, Amuku, Amankalo, Amapo, Amuofufe, Ibinanta, Eziama, Abo, Amoji, Okafia, Amiyi, and Ohumola. Every community has a traditional ruler and a body of Ndiezogo who sit in council with the Ezes. In a recent event, some of the Ezes spoke on various issues about the Igbere nation, particularly the Igbotoma event, which is the major festival that binds the people together.
Ezumezu bu mmemme na ejikota Igbere dum. O mmemme na eme every 3 years. Igbere do our economy and culture do based on the age grade system. Enwo 13 age grades. So every 3 years, the eldest age grade will retire. Oyabu Igbotoma retirement. Then the one next to them will become the eldest. Then a new age grade is admitted into the age grade system. Oya Ezumezuwa, eno ahoyakpa eba, udu ikpa akpa afya. The organihu man will retire. Odohyo wanu ribere, wanu doctor's quarters. So most of the developments in here Igbere go by the age grade. This school here was built by the community. So Iga around Igbere is littered with development projects done by the age grade.
It's one of the town known, and we have seven what we call seven Ukoma. Umu is one of the seven out of the villages in Igbere. Umus is one of the seven people who own Kumasa. We call it a Kumasa in Igbo. Where everything Igbere wants to do, they will go there. If those people decide what to do, what is happening, that everybody will take it like that. Nobody will be fit for me.
The people of Igbere are great farmers and the people proud of their culture, and that is the reason the symbol of the most significant cultural festival in Igbere, The Ibotoma has its insignia, the hoe and the knife, for cultivation. Some sons and daughters of the community, including former governor of Abia State, Ajuzo Kalo, spoke on the significance of the Ejumezu festival.
Ejumezu is a very beautiful thing. You can see all our people from all walks of life are here, and we are one community, common community. We celebrate within our limits.
It is a cultural heritage, and Ibere people decided on their own to make sure that every 3 years they will exhibit all the cultural activities we have in this city, and also to make sure that all our sons and daughters and our visitors will come home, will come to Ibere to witness what we are doing. At the same time, we do have what we call age grade system. The age grade system is an organization that you must find your peers to belong with, and when you are with them, you do what they're doing. And you must, that age grade must find one project or the other to execute and to hand it over to this community. So that after 3 years, then you would have finished. You must find an age grade that would have finished their own tenor, and they will leave the stage, and that age grade takes over. This year, fortunately, is our own turn. The Oganihu age grade of Ibere. That's the progressives in English language. That is what we are.
It's not everyone in your lifetime that you get to see your whole village come together to honor you or to recognize what you have done for the community. So we are happy and we feel very honored. It means that people are watching, so we're very happy.
During the Ibotoma ceremony, other cultural heritage of Ibere people are celebrated. These include the Ibere war dance, Enyi, Okonko, Ojangu, the Jedema dance, and other displays. Each display is associated with a particular village. Ibere, a semi-urban city, has a network of good roads lit with electricity. The self-help effort of the people is unparalleled. The age grade system is the basis for development, as each age grade tries to surpass the project donations in the community. The tower at the Ibere Junction, the Ibere Secondary School building, the Ibere Health Center, and these residential quarters for medical doctors are a few of the projects built and donated to the community by age grades. There are also individual efforts by wealthy sons and daughters of Ibere in the development of Ibere.
Everybody has been hearing of Ibere because of the self efforts of the people of Ibere, the indigenous of Ibere. Everybody is attracted to come home and do edifices that are better than the ones they have in the cities. And it really makes us to have the urge to come home at all times, even no matter how the economy bites. You know, so we're proud, we're happy, you know, and you see, when they come, they don't even want to go.
If you make money in the city, bring it back home so that there won't be mass immigration from the rural area to the city. Let's develop the rural area so that everyone will be developed and it will be better for everyone. And the city will be decongested as well.
We are going to take a break at this juncture, after which the program will continue. Stay tuned. Focusing our attention on Igbere community in Benue local government area. The story of Igbere is an interesting one. It is a story of a people embarking on self-help projects in order to develop their community. You can see that the result is quite amazing when you consider the number of projects that have been executed by the various aid groups. The story continues.
There is also federal presence in Igbere. The Information and Communication Technology ICT Center, located at the Igbere Secondary School, is the effort of the federal government, facilitated by an Igbere son, who is a member of the Federal Character Commission, Dr. Iboko Imo Iboko.
The computer center in the Igbere Secondary School, even as we are talking, they are putting finishing touches. We went in, we met the National or the Nigerian Communication Commission. We discussed with them how they will assist us to provide a computer center for not only Ibere, for the whole geographical zone surrounding Igbere. In other words, a large computer outfit that will serve the interests of Igbere people, the interests of our neighbors in Igbere, the interests of our neighbors in Alai, and the interests of our neighbors in Abreba and Ozuitem and Umuhezechi. So I am essentially, by the grace of God, the facilitator attracting this to Igbere.
ICT Center is a Nigerian Communication Commission empowerment through what we call this, the Service Provision Fund. The Service Provision Fund is for school knowledge center like this. But this one was attracted to Igbere by Dr. Iboko Imo Iboko, who happened to be in the Federal Character Commission. So he attracted the National Communication Commission to site this ICT center in this place. Already, the students have started learning computer before with only one laptop or two. But with the provision of 40 laptops and this center here, I know that my students will, because their major entrepreneur subject is data processing. They will be more enlightened and they will be more professional. And secondly, we are going to train people outside those who are interested.
So not just for students.
It's not only, we are going to, it's a center for knowledge. Remember, it's service knowledge, school knowledge center. It's both, it's for school. Those who other schools around that does not have this type of facility, will now, if they apply to come, we incorporate them and teach them. They will study the whole thing.
For his part, the Abia State government is intervening at the Were Health Center with some health personnel.
This happened last anniversary, 3 years
ago. Should I bring
it? Put more for me. Someone battered him with acid. Where did it happen? Cotonou? Benin Republic. At Benin Republic.
So, how did he get back to Nigeria?
He stayed there for some time and was transferred to Aba, one hospital at Aba. He stayed there for 1 year and 2 months. So the person who was serving by then brought him back to Ibere and asked us to continue the treatment.
So what's the progress now?
You've seen it now. That when he came, everywhere, all this area. So we've been treating him for almost 2 years now. February will be 2 years that we have been treating. And I thank God, he's almost okay.
All right.
As you can see.
Looking at the king's mouth, one would think he never suckled the mother's breast or had never tasted the roasted pear. This is the story of Ibere, which though is among the communities born with silver spoons in their mouth, has its own share of problems. One of such problems is erosion. Various erosion sites had in the past threatened the community, but were reclaimed by the intervention of good-spirited Ibere people. However, the first erosion site in Ibere history, which once threatened to cut Ibere in two, still persists.
This road has been threatening us. Coming to this place, we cannot come in with our vehicle. Most of our family members, they have bought land and other area and relocated. The thing has been threatening so much that nothing is going on in this place, but we have to maintain our house. We cannot run away from our place.
This erosion has been affecting our house, and we've been dozing all along this road since this erosion began in the 60s.
This road used to be a major road that linked Abreba or Hafia and Ihechioa with the people of Ibere. A major road it used to be, but today it is no longer a major road as the people have deserted it owing to a gully erosion of about 500 meters. Though it has been checked somewhere there, but this place has remained impassable as the people, for instance, the owners of this building, are now crying for government intervention. Will this road ever receive attention? Only time will tell.
Ibere is a community that has produced three governors in Dr. Oju Zokalo, former governor of Abia State, Navy Captain Emmanuel Lukebu, former military governor of Anambra State, and Commodore Amadi Ikweche, past military governor of Old Imo State. Suddenly, when the roll call and documentation of Nigeria's past governors shall be made, Ibere undoubtedly will be ranked first on the list of communities that have harvested the most number of governors in Nigeria.
Oh yeah.
Especially their age grade system, which is a catalyst for community development. Thanks for your company. I will see you next week. I am Chimezie Ozems. Bye for now.